Before we commence, I will do giveaway for 5,000 subscribers. So if you want, subscribe. You can leave suggestions in comment section. What would you like for giveaway? Who knows? Maybe I won't fix it. How good are Brooklyn Nets really? When they were assembled, and I mean for Big 3, there was so much hype. Are they really clear favorite to come out of the East? In 2008, Boston Celtics were NBA champions. That was first season of their Big 3. And these Brooklyn Nets have some similarities with that team. And it wasn't easy run at all. 7 games against young and decent Atlanta Hawks. 7 games against 23 years old LeBron. 6 games against what was left of Detroit Pistons. And 6 games against Lakers, who were still finding themselves after Paul Gasol's arrival late in that season. And do you know how they did it?
Let me break it down for you guys. We committed on the defensive end. When you guys consider yourself NBA experts, can pick the Lakers to beat us in 6 games, when we're on TV all the time, so it's not like you don't get to watch us play, I have questions for you guys. We won 66 games. We had the best defense in the NBA.
Defense. Tom Thibodeau was assistant coach. And like you can see, they had the man, the myth, the legend on their roster.
He elevated! Did he elevate or what?
And do you know how many more chips Boston Celtics won? In 2011, Miami failed to secure championship, and their Big 3 was in best years for playing basketball. 3rd in offensive rating, 5th in defensive rating. So we can see from examples not so far ago, it's hard to win in first year. So why so much hype around Brooklyn Nets? Similar to Boston Celtics, their stars are aging. And contrary to those 2008 Boston Celtics, 2 of them came back from serious injuries, and 1 is 1 sandwich away of being fat. So what are comparative advantages of Brooklyn Nets? First in field goal percentage and points per game, astonishing numbers, but is it sustainable? Of course, not. Warriors in their historical season 73-9 had lower field goal percentage, and Nets are currently second in possession per game. Bunch of oldies running the floor. That style of play can wear them down. 3rd in offensive rating and 4th in defensive. 4th from the last, and you just cannot win without defense. AD and Howard as enforcer. Toronto Raptors, Warriors with defensive system and so many dirty plays from Draymond Green and Iguodala, who apparently never committed foul. You cannot win without those type of players. And main problem is gameplay. They had Jarrett Allen and they were also lousy on defense. And you cannot rely on this offense, it's not sustainable. They say KD plays MVP basketball, they say he's good as can be. 2 letters, BS. In this stage of season, there are a bunch of guys playing MVP season, but can they translate it to the winning? Of course not. You have to consider option that KD is right now on his fresh legs. As the season progresses, it will be much harder for him to play on MVP level. And one curiosity, media tell us that KD is in his prime and expect from him to play on this level for at least 2 more years. And in the same time, he plays with DeAndre Jordan, who is considered as finished, and he is same age as KD without any serious injuries. And this Big 3, are they hungry for victory like those in 2008 and 2011? KD would be somewhere else if his main goal was to win rings. It seems to me that he chose Brooklyn just to be more relaxed and play with lower expectations. And now Big 3 happened. Now he has to play to win. Also, before Warriors, he wasn't much of a ring lord.
Durant to the jumper. The man guarded by Iguodala with some help.
So watch this. Green is playing what we call an ISO blue. And
Durant in trouble entangling from Barnes and takes the shot.
On this side.
A minute 25 to go. Durant for 3. Can't find anybody. Like Durant came from out of bounds and they turn it over. And Curry just runs it out. And that will...
And in Warriors, let me put it this way. Me playing alongside Stephen Clay in great system where everyone knows his role. Easily 10 points per game. And this is me being humble. As for James Harden, he's most hungry player in NBA right now. Yes, he disappeared couple of times in playoffs. Even once was benched when his team made historical comeback. But I feel James Harden is ready to do anything to win, and don't expect from him those crazy numbers from Rockets. Like KD, he's exiting his prime. Also, I don't think he will get so many calls anymore. He was considered a superstar. Rockets were very popular in China, biggest NBA market. Of course that league was kind to him. Now, as third player on his team, officiating in East is slightly different. And Kyrie? Maybe just for Kyrie you can say that he won. But media are not kind to him, contemplating all trades possible to involve Kyrie, and he also makes wrong moves here and there. As for coaching staff, rookie coach and assistant coach who never won, and he had comparative advantage with Phoenix Suns. Colangelo was making new rules and also was making team to be best fit for those rules. And mentality wise, Jay Williams said it best.
This is the most polarizing team in NBA history. Think about it, on the same team, we got burner accounts, honey buns, and the earth is flat. On the same team, okay? And here's the thing, like, say hello to your new villain.
I'm not kind of person that falls for the stats. After all I presented to you, something factual, something not. Brooklyn Nets, with no winning culture, with Big 3, where so many things can go wrong. In my very, not so humble opinion, Brooklyn Nets won't even come out from the East. So we'll have to wait to see who was right, me or experienced NBA analyst.
I ain't say they can win the chip because the Lakers waiting for you with Anthony Davis and LeBron. So you might need Kyrie for that. But to get to the finals, they don't even need Kyrie. Kyrie could take the rest of the year off and Brooklyn will go to the finals.